Good morning all. Today we'll be dealing with a new topic, bleaching, bleaching of tooth. So these are the contents. First, introduction, then tooth discoloration. That is the causes of tooth discoloration. There are different causes of tooth discoloration. We will discuss in this. Then the etiology of tooth discoloration, classification of tooth discoloration. There are two types, extrinsic tooth discoloration and intrinsic tooth discoloration. Then to the treatment modalities. There are different treatment modalities we do for discoloration, tooth discoloration. That is, for example, bleaching is one among the treatment modality we give for discolored tooth. Others are, we can go for crowns, we can go for veneers, etc. Then indications for bleaching, contraindications, then history, then the different bleaching materials used, that is the composition, the mechanism, then the techniques we use, different techniques of bleaching. We have intracoronal and extracoronal tooth bleaching. Intracoronal tooth bleaching, we can again subdivide that into walking bleach, thermocatalytic, inside outside bleaching. Then extracoronal, again it is in-office bleaching, home bleaching. Then the effect of bleaching on the supporting structures. The different alternatives to bleaching, which we have already told, we can go for veneers, we can go for crowns, all those alternatives. Then recent advances in bleaching and conclusion. So what is tooth discoloration? It's a clinical problem in dental practice. The various etiology, appearance, localization, severity, and adherence to the tooth structure. So variety of tooth whitening techniques are available. Now, the tooth discoloration is defined as any change in hue, color, or translucency of a tooth due to any cause, frustrating filling materials, drugs, pulp necrosis, or hemorrhage. So class, there are different reasons for tooth discoloration. We can basically or grossly we can divide that into extrinsic tooth discoloration, intrinsic tooth discoloration, and combination. So what are the things that come under extrinsic tooth discoloration and what are the intrinsic sources of tooth discoloration? The extrinsic sources are, one is food and beverages, then mouthwashes or mouth rinses what we use, that is like chlorhexidine, then tobacco products, different respiratory materials, chromogenic bacteria, poor oral hygiene, then swimmer's scalpelus, gingival hemorrhage, and metallic stains. In intrinsic causes are, one is most common, that is aging. Once you age, the tooth color changes, that becomes more yellow because of the loss of enamel, dentin gets exposed and it becomes more yellowish. Then pulp necrosis, that is due to trauma, pulp damage can come and that will lead to the necrosis of the pulp that can cause discoloration. Then intrapulpal hemorrhage, then calcific metamorphosis, drugs like tetracycline and diseases like porphyria. There is another classification also, that is the patient-related causes, and we can classify that again into patient-related causes and dentist-related causes. Patient-related causes, again, pulp necrosis, intrapulpal hemorrhage, calcific metamorphosis, age, developmental defects in the tooth structure, and drug-related causes. Then the dentist-related or the operator-related causes, they are endodontically treated tooth, that is, pulp remnants in the tooth, pulp tissue remnants in the tooth, then intracanal medicaments that we use during the endodontic treatment, then the different obturating materials that also can discolor the tooth. Then restoration related, that is the different restorative materials we use. They are amalgam, pins and posts, composites, etc., which can cause to discoloration of the tooth. So the extrinsic stains, that the stains that occur on the tooth, that can be basically divided into three types, that is type 1, type 2, and type 3, N1, N2, and N3. This classification is given by NATHU, N-A-T-H-O, NATHU's classification of extrinsic stains. These are the discolorations. clinical photographs of the different discolorations, dental caries, chromophilic bacteria, then diet-related causes, that is tea, coffee stains, etc. This is gingival hemorrhage, chlorhexidine strain, stains, then metallic stains. This is Swimmer's calculus, then tobacco stains. Then coming to intrinsic stains, stains due to odontogenesis and stains during post-eruption, that is stains during odontogenesis and that is pre-eruption and stains during post-eruption. So pre-eruptive are alkaptonuria, amelogenesis imperfecta, dentinogenesis imperfecta, fluorosis, erythroblastosis fetalis, porphyria, sickle cell anemia, and tetracycline staining. Post-eruptive causes, stains are age, dental materials we use, foods and beverages, idiopathic pulpal recession, non-alloy dental materials, and traumatic injuries. So these are the different clinical conditions: alkaptonuria, amelogenesis imperfecta, dentinogenesis imperfecta. The Shields classification of dentinogenesis imperfecta is type 1, type 2, and type 3. Then fluorosis. Fluorosis. What is fluorosis? That is, if the excessive intake of fluorides can cause fluorosis. The optimum level is 1 parts per million. If it is more than 1 parts per million, then it can cause fluorosis. These are the different Dean's gradings for fluorosis. Erythroblastosis fetalis, that is a neonatal RH incompatibility. Agglutination and hemolysis of erythrocytes forms hemosiderin. Color ranges from brown to greenish blue. Porphyria, another clinical condition, and sickle cell anemia and thalassemia. All these are causes for intrinsic staining. Then this is a clinical picture of tetracycline staining, tetracycline tooth discoloration. There are 3 grades based on the severity. That is, type 1 or grade 1 is light yellow or gray stain. Grade 2 is yellow brown or deeper gray stain. Grade 3 is brownish yellow or blue gray stain with distinctive banding. And grade 4 is severe stains. Then stains during post-eruption period. That is age, the different dental materials we use, food and beverages, then traumatic injury. Then indications and contraindications of bleaching. That we'll deal when we start with bleaching. So what is bleaching? It is a treatment modality involving an oxidative chemical reaction that increases the perception of lightness. So the topic of bleaching will continue in the next class. Thank you.